Amma ba'd, brothers and sisters, continuing with the narration in which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave a similitude for those who mention Allah and those who don't mention Allah as those who are alive and those who are dead. The narration in the books of Al-Imam Al-Bukhari and Muslim on the authority of Abu Musa Al-Ash'ari. We go on in life and we have this tendency of becoming heedless of Allah Azza wa Jal and the mention of Allah Azza wa Jal. And humankind by nature are faulty. And this heedlessness and sin tend to make the heart hard and rusty, and thus needs cleansing and softening. Abu Darda, may Allah be pleased with him, said, everything has a tool or a means to purify it and cleanse it. And the cleansing of the heart is by mentioning Allah, the Almighty. And this is but one of many other benefits one obtains and gains from mentioning Allah Azza wa Jal. Indulging in the remembrance and mention of Allah Azza wa Jal, reciting dhikr, is something that repels the devil and protects the person from him. Remembering Allah Azza wa Jal is a means of reviving the heart, strengthening the heart, and this reflects on the person's outer appearance. You see some people sometimes and you say, mashallah, their face is so bright. This is the result and the benefit one gains from mentioning Allah Azza wa Jal frequently. Remembering Allah Azza wa Jal frequently increases the glorification, makes a person glorify and exalt Allah the Almighty even more, because he is in continuous mention of his Lord. It makes the person please Allah and thus gain his love and become near to him. And this is the foundation of joy and happiness in this life and salvation in the hereafter. The more we mention Allah Azza wa Jal, the more we'll be mindful and watchful of him, subhanahu wa ta'ala, until the slave excels and ascends to reach a high rank, the rank of Ihsan, where he worships Allah Azza wa Jal as if he can see Allah Azza wa Jal watching him. One of the best deeds by which one draws nearer to Allah Azza wa Jal is mentioning Allah. And thus, it is a means of removing your sins. Allah Azza wa Jal says, إِنَّ الْحَسَنَاتِ يُذْهِبْنَ السَّيِّئَاتِ. Indeed, good deeds remove misdeeds. Don't we all want to be forgiven? Don't we all strive hard in order to get as much reward as we can? Well, dhikr, as simple and easy and facilitated as it is, gets you this. Allah Azza wa Jal says in the Quran, وَالذَّاكِرِينَ اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا وَالذَّاكِرَاتِ أَعَدَّ اللَّهُ لَهُمْ مَغْفِرَةً وَأَجْرًا عَظِيمًا. Those men and women who abundantly mention Allah Azza wa Jal, Allah has prepared for them forgiveness and abundant reward. in the books of an Imam al-Bukhari and Muslim, on the authority of Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, may Allah be pleased with him, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allah Azza wa Jal has angels other than the angels who are there to record the deeds of mankind, who wander around looking for gatherings in which Allah Azza wa Jal is being mentioned. Gatherings of dhikr. Until they find a group of people, and then they start calling one another, Halummu, come. We found what we're looking for. And then they surround them in layers until they reach the heavens, the worldly sky, as-sama'u dunya, the closest to earth. And then Allah Azza wa Jal will ask them, though He knows the answer, subhanahu wa ta'ala. What are my slaves saying? They would say, they are exalting you, glorifying you, and praising you. Allah will then ask them, did they see me? The angels will say, no, we swear by you, O Allah, they never saw you. Allah will then ask them, how will they be? How would their situation be if they see me? The angels will say, they will exalt you, glorify you, and praise you even more. Then Allah will ask them, what are they asking of me? They say, or they will say, they're asking you to grant them Jannah, paradise. Allah will ask them, have they seen it? They will say, no, we swear by you, our Lord. They haven't seen it. Allah will ask them, how will their situation be if they were to see it? Or if they were to see it, they would say, they will strive harder in order to obtain it and long even more for it. Then Allah will ask them, what are they seeking refuge in me from? They will say, the fire of hell. Allah will ask them, have they seen it? They will say, no, we swear by you, our Lord. They haven't seen it. Allah will then ask them, how will their situation be if they were to see it? They will answer, they will run away from it as far as they could and strive hard to protect themselves from it. Allah will then say, I make you witness, O my angels, that I have forgiven them. A simple task that doesn't take much to perform results in this great prize from Allah Azza wa Jalla. We ask Allah Azza wa Jalla to bless us with His bounties and to make our tongues always moist with His mention. Allahumma ameen. Now, Allah Azza wa Jalla says, وَلَا تَكُونُوا كَالَّذِينَ نَسُوا اللَّهَ فَأَنْسَاهُمْ أَنْفُسَهُمْ. Don't be like those who had forgotten Allah and thus He made them forget themselves. Ibn Kathir said, commenting on this verse, these are people who shun the mention of Allah, who abandon dhikr, and therefore Allah Azza wa Jal will make them heedless of what's beneficial for them in this life and in the hereafter. And this is another benefit of mentioning Allah Azza wa Jal. We all have to talk. It's necessary to talk. And one way to protect ourselves from indulging in sins or partially indulging in sins is to keep in the tongue busy with the dhikr and the mention and the remembrance of Allah Azza wa Jal. Otherwise, we see this and it's commonly spread, backbiting, gossiping, lying, immoral talk, obscene words. Isn't this true? The way to safeguard your tongue from falling into this is to keep it busy with something beneficial. And the most beneficial thing to do and to use the tongue with is the mention of Allah. Otherwise, the threat of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, as in the narration of Ma'ad, reported by At-Tirmidhi, classified as authentic by Al-Albani, he told him at the end of a very long narration, he said, what makes people be thrown into fire on their noses, in another narration, on their faces, other than the consequence of their tongues? This tongue is a lethal weapon which can result in us going to hell if it's not properly used. If someone very important, a king, a president, a prince, or a celebrity, goes on TV live and says so and so by name is praised with me and he's dear to me, how would we feel? Whoa. It's like, that's the day of the life, right? How would the case be when the one saying that is Allah? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, reporting on his Lord, on behalf of his Lord, this is a Qudsi narration. This is reported by Al-Bukhari and Muslim, narrated by Abu Huraira. Allah Azza wa Jal said, if my slave mentions me to himself, I will mention him to myself. And if he mentions me in a group or a gathering, I will mention him in a gathering better than his, meaning to the angels. Not only that, which is a benefit indeed, it's an honor rather than a benefit. Another honor is that Allah boasts about you. Abu Sa'id al-Khudri, narrated as reported by Imam Muslim, that Muawiyah, may Allah be pleased with him, one time walked out and saw people in a circle. He said, what are you doing? What were you talking about? They said, we were praising Allah and mentioning Allah. He said, I ask you by Allah, is this what you were doing? They said, by Allah, this is what we were doing. He said, I did not ask you because I doubted what you said. But the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam one day walked out and the companions were in a circle and he asked them the very question, what were you doing? What were you talking about? And they said, we were praising Allah, thanking him for the bounty of Islam and that he blessed us with you. He said, Allahu, I ask you by Allah, is this what you were doing and saying? They said, by Allah, this is what we were doing and saying. He said, I did not say this or ask you this because I doubt you. But indeed, Jibreel came to me and said that Allah boasts about you to the angels. Allahu Akbar. We all have problems in life that affect our hearts and our psychological situation and make some of us go into depression. And we long to have peace and tranquility in our hearts and in our lives. Mention Allah and this will happen. Abu Hurairah narrated, and this is reported by Imam Muslim, that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, never will a group of people gather to mention Allah azza wa jalla, except that angels would surround them. Mercy and tranquility will descend upon them, and Allah azza wa jalla will make mention of them to those with him, meaning the angels. Mentioning Allah Azza wa Jal is a means of increasing your fear of Allah Azza wa Jal. Allah Azza wa Jal says, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا ذُكِرَ اللَّهُ وَجِلَتْ قُلُوبُهُ. The true believers are but those whom, when the mention of Allah Azza wa Jal is made in front of them, when Allah is mentioned before them, their hearts become more fearful. And protection from the utter loss in the hereafter results from the mention of Allah. Allah Azza wa Jal says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تُلْهِكُمْ أموالكم ولا أولادكم عن ذكر الله ومن يفعل ذلك فأولئك هم الخاسرين. O you who have believed, let not your wealth and your children distract you, prevent you from the mention of Allah, from the remembrance of Allah. And those who do so are indeed the utter losers. So when they don't get distracted and indulge and busy themselves with the remembrance of Allah Azza wa Jal, they safeguard themselves of falling into the category of losers in this life and in the hereafter. We ask Allah Azza wa Jal to make us amongst the winners in this life and in the hereafter. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. وبعد. الله عز وجل says, ومن أعرض عن ذكري فإن له معيشة ضنكا. Those who shun my remembrance will indeed have a miserable life. You want to protect yourselves from misery, grief, and sadness in this life? Busy yourself with the remembrance of Allah Azza wa Jalla. Make it a common practice and a frequent practice to mention Allah Azza wa Jalla all your time. Sheikh Ibn Baz, may Allah have mercy on him, was an amazing personality. Whenever he was not talking, whenever he was listening to people, his tongue would not stop mentioning Allah Azza wa Jalla. It will only stop when he had to respond. You want to be rescued in the hereafter? Mu'adh, may Allah be pleased with him, narrated, and this is reported by a Tirmidhi classified as authentic by Al-Albani, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, there is nothing the son of Adam can do that will protect him from the punishment of Allah the Almighty better than mentioning Allah the Exalted. Simple. Simple. What does it take to say Subhanallah wa bihamdihi Subhanallah al-Azim? Nothing. How long did it take me to say it now? How long does it take to say Subhanallah wa bihamdihi 100 times? لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد وهو على كل شيء قدير 100 times. How much of our day would it take if you compare it to idle talk, to eating, to drinking, to chatting, surfing the net? Nothing. Incomparable. You want to get a reward that's better than jihad? Better than spending charity? Mention Allah. Remember Allah. Recite dhikr. That's not my words. These are the words of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Abu Darda, may Allah be pleased with him, narrated, and this is again reported by At-Tirmidhi, classified as authentic by Al-Albani, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam once asked the companions, should I not tell you about something that is the best of your deeds, the most pleasing to your Lord, and will make you obtain the highest of ranks? And it's better than you spending gold and silver, and you striking the necks of your enemy, and they striking your necks, in jihad that is. They said, indeed, O Messenger of Allah. He said, the remembrance of Allah. Again, a simple task and an abundant, huge reward. You want to plant your trees from now in Jannah? Mention Allah. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud narrated, and this is reported by At-Tirmidhi, classified as sound by Al-Albani, that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, I met Ibrahim alayhi salatu wa sallam on the night when I was taken up, ascended to the heavens, and he said to me, O Muhammad, convey my salam to your ummah, to your nation, and tell them that the soil of Jannah is pure, and that the water of Jannah is fresh and sweet, and that it is a flat, treeless plain, and that the seeds of this plain is subhanallah, walhamdulillah, wa la ilaha illallah, wallahu akbar. If Allah blesses us and enables us to utter these with the intention of planting trees for ourselves in Jannah, you think someone will be having trees in Jannah and not attend and not be admitted? It's in his name, so he's got to be there. What is the connection between us and Allah? This is another rather magnificent prize from Allah Azza wa Jalla. What is the connection between us and Allah? As Muslims, we don't have middlemen. We don't have mediators between us and Allah, not even Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It's a direct relationship between us and Allah through supplicating Him, imploring Him, dua. And we strive hard to make our dua accepted. Well, the remembrance of Allah Azza wa Jal, dhikr, gives you this, assures you this, guarantees you this. Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu narrated, and this is reported by Al-Bayhaqi, classified as sound by Al-Albani, that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, there are three types of people whose supplications will not be rejected by Allah. The first one is the ones who frequently mention Allah. Number two, the oppressed. And number three, a just ruler. It's the sunnah of Allah. It's the way of Allah, the divine way of Allah Azza wa Jal, that we're afflicted, that we're struck with calamities and hardships. The way out of these, very simple and easy, legislated to us in Islam, is by the remembrance of Allah Azza wa Jal. Where is this coming from? From the story of Prophet Yunus alayhi salatu wasalam, when he was swallowed by the whale. فَلَوْلَا أَنَّهُ كَانَ مِنَ الْمُسَبِّحِينَ لَلَبِثَ فِي بَطْنِهِ إِلَى يَوْمِ يُبْعَثُونَ. And had it not been that he was amongst those who frequently uttered tasbih, he would have stayed inside the whale until the day they were resurrected. So Allah Azza wa Jal relieved him from this hardship by his remembrance of Allah, by the virtue of mentioning and remembering Allah. Brothers and sisters, scholars mentioned many more as benefits from the mention and remembrance of Allah Azza wa Jal. Ibn al-Qayyim alone mentioned 100 benefits for uttering and reciting dhikr and remembering Allah. But what we've mentioned so far, if it was only one of each of these, as the only benefit of dhikr and the remembrance of Allah Azza wa Jal, it would have been sufficient as a motivator to encourage us to frequently move our lips and tongue with the mention and the remembrance of Allah Azza wa Jal. We ask Allah Azza wa Jal to bless us, enable us to mention Him as frequent as would result in obtaining all these benefits and more. Allahumma ameen. Allahumma aghfir lana dhunubana wa israfana fi amrina wa thabbit aqdamana wa ansurna ala